this world would make us powerful. Money, sex appeal, and knowledge. If you have wealth, you're considered powerful by society, because you have the money for a reason, and therefore, you're meant to be worshipped. Or alternatively, money can be used to put yourself in positions of power. Cough, Donald Trump, cough. In terms of sex appeal, the media idolizes those who are beautiful. Those with thin waistlines, full lips, and big muscles are the ones who make big movies, make the front covers. They're all we hear about, and they're all we see. The third thing I mentioned, though, was knowledge. It is probably the most underrated form of power in the developed world. With knowledge comes independence, opportunity, wealth, love, and happiness. In fact, knowledge has so much power that people will undermine and tear apart those that seek it and have obtained it. Clear examples of this are shown daily within schoolyards across the nation. So why do we tear down and shun those that want to further their knowledge and make themselves better with this knowledge? What are the consequences associated with the attainment of knowledge? And how does knowledge equal power? First up, what is power? Power, by definition, grants the ability to be able to do something or act in a particular way. Essentially, the more power you have, the more freedom you have, and by extension, happiness. Money and fame, as I mentioned earlier, are things that give you this power. Knowledge, however, gives it in another way. Side note here, you could use knowledge to make yourself wealthy and famous, but I'm looking at it in a slightly different light. So back to knowledge offering opportunity. Let's think about it. There is not a single problem that couldn't be solved if you knew how to solve it. No amount of strength, money, or fame could immediately solve the problem like simply knowing the answer could. So straight away, in this sense, knowledge offers you opportunity, as you can solve any problem if you know enough about it. Not only does it offer opportunity, but it offers independence as well. Knowledge offers you independence. Let me explain. If someone doesn't know how to tie their own shoes, for example, you'd be dependent on someone else to do it or show them how to. And straight away, it seems to make so much more sense to have them be taught. There's even an old saying that says it's better to teach than just to do it for them. You give a man a fish, you feed him for a day. You teach him to fish, you feed him for a lifetime, because he has the knowledge needed to feed himself. Very cliche, but it definitely highlights my point. The more you know, the more independent you are, as you don't need people to do things for you, which makes us powerful. Interestingly, this concept of knowledge offering independence can be extended through to love as well. I mentioned earlier that knowledge can bring you wealth and love. What do I mean by that? Well, with knowledge of how people are social, you can build relationships, both platonic and romantic. You are finding love using knowledge, and it's this love we share with others that makes us wealthy and powerful. Knowledge here gives us the power to find love, which makes us not only wealthy and independent, but happy as well. But if knowledge is so powerful that it gives us this freedom, opportunity, independence, wealth, and love through and existing as power, why do we shy away from it? Especially when it's the knowledge that's making us powerful. For some reason, it's considered a bad thing to be knowledgeable and to want to further your own knowledge in school and in some cases out in the big world. The kicker, though, is that people know that knowledge offers opportunity and that you're far more likely to succeed in life just generally knowing more. Yet people bully and demean others for success, for asking questions, for being excited about learning something new, trying to strip them of the power that they hold. Furthermore, there's this culture in schools that teachers are the enemy, even though they are the ones offering the knowledge and skills. It's always, she's such a bad teacher, we shouldn't have to do this. Why are we doing this homework? And it's not fair is also another common one. Something I found incredibly ironic, though, was that as I was writing this exact part of the speech, a year 12 student was kicked out of the library study area after a shouting match with a teacher, literally shouting for refusing to hand over his phone because it was distracting himself and others from their work. Here's a prime example of what's going wrong in schools. He fails to recognize that learning is a privilege, that he is literally choosing to be at school, and the knowledge he would gain being at school would provide him with the power to do whatever he wanted to do, like not have to hand over his phone. It just doesn't seem to make sense. But it's an attitude that is reflected in the majority of students from about grade 3 to grade 12, which is messed up. And it's something that stems from tall poppy syndrome, attempting to shift the power balance resting on knowledge. Tall poppy syndrome is essentially where you cut down and demean someone for their success, because you feel like they have a power over you. Whether it's academic, sporting, or community recognition that these people receive, there is always someone there to cut them down and belittle that achievement, removing the power that they gain from knowledge. Australia is one of the worst countries in the world for this syndrome, and people are afraid to succeed, to further their own knowledge, and by extension, gain the power they deserve. Something that I'm not proud to admit is that I've been sucked into this mentality. Just the other week, a friend of mine, let's call him David, won age champion for the 18-year-old cross country, which is amazing. And the school recognised this achievement with a medal and a certificate in front of the whole school, as he deserved. Afterwards, though, I found out that he was the only one that had actually participated, so it was a short thing. And when this knowledge came to light, myself and others heckled him for getting age champion for coming dead last. David then went on to tell me, though, that he felt almost ashamed to receive this award. And I realised what I'd done. I belittled his achievement and cut him down because I felt like he had some sort of power over me, which is ridiculous, but it's clearly how I felt. And what's unfortunate is that this mentality is a positive feedback loop. People are afraid to succeed because they feel like they might be cut down. So they fail to learn what they need to learn or do what they need to do, so then they feel stupid and they go on to cut others down in positions of power. This cycle just goes on and on, with dreams crushed and any chance of gaining power through knowledge down the drain. Sobering reality. But there is something we can do about it. It sounds simple, but it comes down to promoting an environment where it's inspiring to see others gain power through knowledge, and not shameful. As right now, seeing another person's success seems to feel like our own failure. Seeing someone strong seems to make us feel weak. Seeing someone intelligent seems to make us feel stupid. If we can highlight the importance of not comparing ourselves to others, and instead aspiring to be more like them, the power of not only individuals, but of society as a whole, would improve dramatically as we learnt more and succeeded more. Money and fame can bring power. We know that. But knowledge brings different forms of power. Any knowledge we gain gives us the power to succeed through opportunity, independence, wealth, love, and happiness. This power is achievable through the creation of safe environments where it's normal and inspiring to succeed and learn, rather than embarrassing and shameful. This will decrease the amount of poppy syndrome present in schools today. Because I would rather live in a world ruled by people who gain power through knowledge rather than money and fame. And I have no doubt you do as well, because knowledge is power.